guys, MKBHD here, and this is iPhone 10, and it's my favorite iPhone ever by far. And there's no doubt that in the history of iPhones, this thing is iconic. It's more modern, it finally feels like a new iPhone. That's a big part of why I like it so much, but that's also the source for a few sore spots. There's a learning curve to this phone, unlike any other iPhone. You see, every other iPhone ever has just been home button, rectangle, screen, rounded corners, pretty much the same thing. You know what you're getting yourself into, you know exactly how to use it, and if there's maybe one big new feature every year, it takes you 2 seconds to learn it and you're good. iPhone 10 is different. With this phone, there's maybe three or four big fundamental changes to the way you use the phone. Now, it's very clearly still an iPhone. You still mostly know how to use it, but there's a couple things that are different that you'll have to get used to. So on the outside, it's the shape we're used to, the rectangle with rounded corners, but this is the first time the display itself actually has curved corners, and it's pushed right up to the edges of the phone, or at least closer than they've ever been. The commercials make it seem a little more dramatic than it actually is, but hey, it's 2017, phones have small bezels, that's just the way they are now, so in that way, the iPhone catches up. And it pushes everything to the corners and keeps all the front-facing sensors in the notch, that forsaken notch at the top. It's actually not that big of a deal, but we'll get into that soon. Just holding the phone though, it feels great. I think it's an awesome size, but if there were a bigger iPhone 10 Plus, I would totally get that. Right now, despite the larger display, the 10 is definitely closer to feeling like an iPhone 8 than an 8 Plus. It still feels like a smaller phone compared to the others I've used. And also, thanks to the stainless steel sides, it's definitely slippery, and it's definitely going to slide out of your pocket at least once. It happens to the best of them. And it's crazy, the silver, it's so shiny. And honestly, we all know your phone is never going to look as good as it does fresh out the box. Unlike the more matte finish of the previous iPhone, I'm not convinced this super shiny finish on the iPhone's rails is going to last like this. We've seen this before in other products. It definitely gets chipped and scratched. You probably already know I usually go for a matte black skin here, which, not gonna lie, still looks pretty good. But dbrand's got something new for the 10, the grip. So like the name implies, this thing is supposed to be the best way to grip your phone. Look for a full review of this bumper later this month, but I'll leave a link below if you want to check this one out. A lot of people were asking about it when I showed it in my Instagram story. But overall, it's a pretty complete hardware package, as you'd expect from a $1,000 smartphone. You know, it's the speakers, even though they aren't front-facing, are still pretty good. It's water-resistant, which gives you some nice peace of mind. It has wireless charging. This is no headphone jack. Welcome to 2017. But overall, it's well-considered and well-put together. Is it now officially the most breakable iPhone ever, thanks to having glass on the back? Yes. Yes. The one part of the hardware of this phone I actually really don't like is the camera bump, but not just for the usual reason, like rocking on a table. I've just kind of accepted that at this point. But because of the new orientation, a couple times I've noticed it's easy to accidentally get your finger in the photo or video you're taking, just because it's all up in the corner. It might take a couple days to get used to that and stop getting your finger in the corner of your shots. But what's really become the signature feature of the iPhone 10 is around the front, and it is that notch up at the top of the display. And there are two camps with this. Number one is, I hate it, it's ugly, I wish it wasn't there. And number two is, I actually don't notice it anymore. And just like with the Essential phone, I tend to fall more in camp number two. When you want to make a 2017 phone and you want to shrink the bezels, you still have to put all the front-facing sensors, all of the cameras, and the IR blaster, and the depth sensor, you have to put that somewhere. In 2017, some manufacturers keep a smaller traditional bezel to house it. Some try to go no top bezel and put everything in the chin. Some try to minimize all the bezels and use a sort of a cutout notch. Apple has decided to go with a notch. And I don't mind it. In fact, I literally don't even think about it anymore in everyday use. Now, obviously, when you're focusing on it here as I'm talking about it and highlighting it on video, it's really obvious. You know, the unibrow at the top, it kind of just becomes a part of this iPhone X's character, but you're never really looking at it during normal use.